The spiritual head of the order is the Venerable Ajahn Chah. He has come from Thailand for a few weeks to lend his support to the new sanctuary.
ในเวลานี้ชาวตะวันตกนี้กำลัง
Many people in the West today seem to have much dissatisfaction and unhappiness in their hearts, and they feel they don't have a satisfactory means of dealing with it. The teachings of the Buddha offer the practice of meditation, which is a way of solving problems and overcoming confusion. We've been invited over here because many people want to learn how to put the teaching into practice with the aim of finding a path through their confusion towards peace and calm. The ultimate truth is like the flavor of an apple, which you can't see with the eye or hear with the ear. The only way to experience it is to put the teaching into practice. Once you've tasted it, you'll no longer be in any doubt about its flavor, and you won't have to ask anyone else. The problem will be solved.
The abbot, the Venerable Ajahn Chah, has been in robes for 50 years. Here in the forest, you can learn to be in harmony with the way things are in nature. You can live happily and peacefully. Here, a monk is able to contemplate the nature of things. As he looks around him, he understands that all forms of life degenerate and eventually die. Nothing that exists is permanent. And when he understands this, he begins to become calm and serene. Monks are trained to be content with little, to eat only what they need, to sleep only when necessary, to be satisfied with what they have. This is the foundation for Buddhist meditation. Buddhist monks don't practice meditation for selfish reasons. We practice in order to know ourselves, so that then we'll be able to understand and teach others how to live peacefully and wisely. This monk has been ordained for 15 years. He's respected not only for his skill in meditation, but also for his practical skills. Is consistent mindfulness. Meditation doesn't just involve being at peace with the world. Confronting the self can be like walking into a raging storm. It's quite usual at first to despair, even to want to kill oneself.
Some people think that a monk's life is a lazy and an easy one. If that's what they think, they should just try and see how long they can stand it. A monk's work is hard. He works to free his heart so that he begins to feel loving kindness, which embraces everything. He sees that all life has the characteristic of the breath. It rises and it falls. Everything that is born expires. So his suffering diminishes as he knows that nothing belongs to him. To help people contemplate the true nature of the body, we have human skeletons in the assembly hall. Because when one doesn't understand death, life is very confusing.
เอาไว้เพื่อประโยชน์อย่างนั้น
ยานาธัมโมมีจลังอนันตา
ถ้าหากว่าตัวตนเราจริงๆเนี่ย
If our body really belonged to us then it would obey our commandsBut if we say, don't get old, or I forbid you to get sick, does it obey us? No. It takes no notice. We only rent this house. We don't own it. If we think the house belongs to us, when we have to leave it to die, we suffer. In reality, there is no such thing as a self.
อำนาจอันนี้เพราะอะไรเพราะมันไม่ใช่ตัวอนัตตาไม่ใช่ตัวของเราสมมติ
Buddha made a distinction between ultimate truth and conventional truth. The idea of a self is merely a convention. Foreigner, Thai, you, the interviewer. These are all conventions.
สมมติว่าคนสัมภาษณ์เป็นสมมติทั้งนั้นแหละ
In ultimate reality, there isn't anybody. There is only earth, fire, water, air, elements which have combined temporarily. We call the body a person, mine. But ultimately, there is no me. There is only anatta, not self.
Some of the lay community will sit up all night meditating on these themes with the monks. For a brief period, they are inspired and uplifted and become one with the spiritual struggle of the monks.
To understand anatta, not self, you have to meditate. If you only intellectualize about it, your head will explode. Once you understand anatta,Then the burden of life is gone. Your normal daily life with your family, your work, all will be much easier. You'll be at peace with the world.
Anatta ni pen reung mi phol mak. Ni pen reung sang ton hai chareun dai di mak.
When we see beyond self, we no longer cling to happiness. And when we stop clinging, we can begin to be happy.
ทำอะไรสบายมากถ้าห่วงก็ปรินิพพานไม่ได้เลยสิต้องภาวนามาให้ห่วงปรินิพพานถ้าห่วงปรินิพพานก็ไปไม่ได้ไปปรินิพพานไม่ได
้ shouldn't be concerned with nirvana or attaining nirvana if you are then that in itself will prevent you from gaining nirvana
so what should a monk's main concern be
ฉะนั้นพระควรจะมีมุ่งหมายอย่างไรครับ
ฮะ
ฉะนั้นพระจะควรมีมุ่งหมายอย่างไรนะ
มีความมุ่งหมายทางการปล่อยวาง
The aim is to let go
So you have to let go but without striving to let go
ฉะนั้นต้องปล่อยวางแต่ว่าไม่ควรจะปรารถนาการปล่อยวาง
ใช่ปรารถนาไม่ได้นี่ปล่อยวางไม่ปรารถนาสิ่งใดทั้งนั้นน่ะว่าง
That's right. You should let go without desire.
หมด ถ้ามีอยู่ก็ไม่ใช่พระนิพพานนะพี
่ If there's still desire and the pursuit to do that, then that's not nirvana.
วัดป่านี้
So the laity give the monks food for the body, and the monks give the laity food for the mind and heart, so that they can understand the cause of unhappiness and know.Why things are as they are.
ให้มีความเห็นชอบที่ไม่มีปัญหาเกิดขึ้น
Be mindful and let things take their natural course. Then your mind will become still like a clear forest pool. All kinds of rare animals will come to drink at the pool.You will see many wonderful and strange things come and go, but you will be still. Problems will arise, but you will see through them immediately. This is the happiness of the Buddha.